Hello everyone. In this video, I want to demonstrate how you can create a Power Apps connect to your Dynamics 365 Business Central and then retrieve the data from your Business Central and then publish the data back to Business Central. So let's see how it works now. So first, I log into powerapps.com and then I start by creating an app. So when I click on create it, I will select DataWorks. And then it will show you all the connections DataWorks can connect to. I will select Business Central. This is how I can connect it to my Business Central. So there are two options for Business Central. You can either select connect to your Business Central on-premise tenant, or you can connect to your Business Central SaaS tenant. So I'm gonna connect to my Business Central SaaS tenant. Click on create it, and then it will load all the tables and pages which expose through the web services. So while we're still waiting, you can go to our Business Central and search the web services. Okay, so when you look at here, then you could see all the pages, all the queries, all the code unit published. Okay, so we're gonna do a test for the customer. I'm gonna create a customer from my Power Apps. So actually what I'm gonna do is, like, in Power Apps, I'm gonna connect to this customers list. Okay, so let's go back to my Power Apps, and you can see it shows all the companies in my Business Central production instance. I'm gonna click on this Crowness USA Business Central company and then search by this customer, and then I'm gonna connect to this customers V2.0. Click on connect, so it will create the app automatically for you by loading the customer information. And right after this is loaded, then we can run this app. Then we're gonna create a test customer and to see if instead previously it can only retrieve some information from Business Central, and now it can publish the information back to Business Central. That's gonna run this app, and so you can see my customer list, right? So I want to create a test customer and just use my name, but right now you see it only has test one, test two. That's the bottom of this customer list. I'm just gonna create one customer, which is called Jesse Test, okay? And then display name, still call it Jesse Test. You can leave the type blank, and then put in my address here. So this information does not need to be a real one, so that's just put something here, okay? And then confirm it. Let's go back to our Business Central and take a look in the customer list. Oh, you see right away I can see this Jesse Test, this customer has been created with the information I put on in the Power Apps. So this is really cool. If you like the app you created, then you can just save it, publish it. So we can save the app, you can save to the cloud and just give it another. I have a previous app created for customer test, and just gonna create it for customer test too. Okay, so let's save it. And if you like, after you publish, you save this app, you can share with your coworkers. So you can share with anybody within your organization by click on this share button. Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna leave the share for now, but you can type in somebody's email address and share the app with them. Okay, that's it. So I really like it. So with this new improvement for Power Apps, it can have the both way connections. Either you can retrieve the information from Business Central, and then you can push the information back to our Business Central. That's really cool. Thank you so much for watching this YouTube video. I hope to see you guys again next time.
Thank you for watching this ArcherPoint video. Stay in the know with the latest on Microsoft Dynamics by subscribing to our channel. You can also learn more from our blog at archerpoint.com or email info@archerpoint.com to contact us. See you in the next video.